setting out to stand. Those enemies by the...
Byron, and I'll see. see you tomorrow at 9 a.m. sharp, sir. Parsons?
I have to say, this is a lovely spot.
Parsons!
Testing, testing, 1, 2. This is Rooster Byron's dog, Shep. If Byron can't even kill her, to go fuck itself. Air ye. With a pair invested in me by Rooster Johnny Byron, who can't be here on the fact he's in Barbados this week with Kate Moss, I, his faithful little Shep, hereby instruct Kennedy. Council to tell Brian Bluestone and Ross Taylor and their twat son and the sorry cunts of the new estate that this ain't Rooster's right. I am Rooster Byron, and I ain't going nowhere. Happy St. George's Day, now kiss my beggar as you period.
Charge the door. My dogs are right over safe right when the door flings in.
Well, the rest is history. But don't worry. We saved you on.
So you're far from the Coopers then?
What?
I just bumped into Wesley. Says he's borrowed you.
What?
On the account of the fracker.
What fracker?
The fracker in the saloon bar last night.
Bollocks! I ain't quite one. Couple of points, spawn the lemons, come on.
It's not what I heard, mate.
Hang about. First of all, that was not a fracker. Two, even if it was a fracker, it weren't my fault. Daddy asked me for it. I'm in a saloon bar, right? Playing pool, where their stays on. Suddenly, Daddy comes over, slaps down a tenner. I, seven ball in. Ha, he racks, I break, seven ball in. Next minute, he's shoving me in the chest. Says I moved the black while he was in the box. Starts creating. Says I've been burnt lead flats up the Wilcott Road. Says I nicked his mum's PlayStation 3. For a start, I don't know where he lives. Second,
that's not the fracker I'm talking about.
What do you mean?
The way I heard it, Danny leaves. You go to the bar. Vodka Red Bull. Vodka Red Bull. Vodka Red Bull. Vodka Red Bull. Stagger with the gents. 5 minutes later, I come barreling out in your birthday suit, waving your crown jewels everywhere.
Bollocks!
Exactly! Then you pick up Bob Dance's pugging simulator, Ludat. Then you start humping against Martin Fink's Barstool, saying, come on, you old slapper, about the blow show. Then the fracker occurred. You ring the bell. Everyone's silent. You say, you never touched Danny's mum's PlayStation, but you did shag her when Danny's dad was away in the Falklands, making him odds on not Danny's dad, and in which case he should show you some bloody respect.
Hey, Ben, it's coming back. And I can categorically say that that is bollocks. For a start, I was drinking brandy and cokes, and I was not star-cursed. If you examine the CCTV, clearly showed I had my socks on.
I think you'll refer that one upstairs. Mate, it's taken years, but you've finally done it. You're barred from every pub in Flintlock. Phoenix Arms, you broke the bar, they let you back, you locked James Ladd in the freezer cabinet.
He deserved it, Nippy bastard.
No, Rakers, you broke the security camera a week after letting back your pizza boy with a swaddy.
I never started that. Bloody Rambo.
First night back, you set fire to the Christmas tree. Royal Oak, you started doing whiz off the bar during the meat raffle. Then on Kitty's fun day, you slaughtered a live pig in the car park.
It was a rural display.
With Ric Flair!
Ah, that was a bloody big weekend.
Congratulations, you've got the Grand Slam. I think they said it would never happen.
Storm in a teacup, mate. You watch. Oh boy, Danny and Polly. Pop her over the Coopers. Pink suit bug. Butter her up, give her a twinkle. Tanner said they'll be in the snug by last season. And when you see me, mine's a brandy coke.
Mary? Mary, are you there?
Be nice, dear. Play nicely, Ginger, yeah?
I haven't seen anything, mate.
Good morning, Mr. Byron.
Morning, Professor. You're apparently off to the fair, then?
Oh, indeed I am, Mr. Byron. Indeed I am off to the fair. To see a strange outlandish fowl, a quaint baboon, an ape, an owl, a dancing bear, a giant spoon, a warlock shift, a standing stone, a violent jest, a juggler's cheats, a tumbler showing cunning feats, a Morris dancer puppet play, mad Tom to sing around a lay, all this upon St. George's Day. Oh, and here we are, and now I've lost the dog. You haven't seen my Mary around here, have you?
No, Professor. Not this time, no.
Oh, she spies a weasel and that's that. I'll track her through the bracken and the bluebells. Holler myself hoarse for all the good it'll do. Oh, will she come back?
I'm sure she'll bundle up, Professor.
Yes, yes. Of course. Well, it's very good to see you, Mr. Byron. And, who's this? Young lady.
This professor is Ginger. You remember Ginger from last time?
I remember you. You're in maths faculty.
Know me? I'm a DJ.
Since where?
I'm a fucking DJ.
He's an unemployed classroom.
I see. Are you sure apply?
Just a tip, mate. Since Roy, I'm penciled in second with the two chairs that they put out the car rock at the Coopers at sunset. I got my records in the car.
Sorry, mate, you were saying?
A DJ, eh?
That's right, mate.
And, how does that work?
Basically, I spin sit beats, bring up the ruckus, and drop the bomb at the people at the back, because the people at the back don't take no slack.
It's Maureen, isn't it?
That's right, mate, Maureen.
Maureen, Pringle.
Dr. Maureen Pringle, how do you do?
How are you finding the funding cuts over there?
Oh, I think it's disgraceful. I don't see we're going to meet our quotas. It's like a sausage factory.
Well, in the university, it's 1987, it's going to be worse.
I suggest you bring the ruckus.
You just try and stop me.
That's the spirit, Maureen.
I'll tell you what, Maureen.
Doctor Maureen, to you.
I'll tell you what, Doctor. You bob in there, roll us two breaking rolls. I'll roll us then. Spruce up, get down in time for the films.
Only if you tell her I'm a DJ.
You're not a DJ.
You want to say it?
I'll never
say it. You
want to say it? Fuck off! No! No! No!
Say it!
No!
Say it!
No!
Perhaps, Dr. Pringle, a bit sometime.
That would be delightful. I should point out for the record I don't actually have GCSE maths, but I do have a great big airy cock and balls, if that helps. Not too much, mate.
Not great, Pete.
Be taken to the Sergeant Major's this morning, Professor.
I think, given the occasion, anything to Sergeant Major's would be unpatriotic.
So what are we drinking to?
To Titania, to Woden's Wild Hunt, to the Blossom and the Maycomb, to St. George and all the lost gods of England. Our green time is upon us. Summer is begun. Well, I better toggle off. Don't want to miss the floats.
Don't worry about your Mary, Professor. If I see her, I'll send her over.
Adieu, Mr. Byron. To the rebels.
To the rebels, Professor!
Hey, big noise. Tell you what, mate. All going to flip off. Special tables, hot dog bands, biting bumper cars, whirler swirler. All the flutes I'm looking for in this field. There's a Lord of the Rings flute. His numbers, hobbits, orcs, whatnot. Fucking what's his name? Randall. That's the one. Then there's George and the Dragon, Men in Black 2, Crane and Goose on X Factor. Seen as last year, boys ain't make a bloody effort. Although, Roger Poyle that was Sharon Osbourne is generally unsettling. Then, like, in that beer room, you're the graveyard, they've got a wait for it, a healing experience and a massage tent. And I'm not joking, you go in and Pat Cannon is sat on a foldy chair smoking a lamb with a butter. So I've gone, where is the massage, Pat? I'm treated for 6 months, and anyway, it's masseuse. So I say, wait for it.
What's wrong with your shoes?
Oh, mate, I'll tell you what, I'm on fire again.
Morning, mate.
Bastard! You say you weren't here! Where the fuck am I?
Gabbling!
Come and see, mate.
Oh, the shit.
Morning, Ginger. You missed a classic last night, son. Didn't get cracking till after hours. There's whiz, wangers, sick beats, tasty birds, rum and Ribena, bedlin and brandy, birds going, bats for it, banging it back. And then right then.
I can't help you.
Rooster brings his telly out. Credits it all round and smashes it with a cricket bat!
I've never done that, bollocks! I'd never do that, eh?
It's over there, mate.
What?
You had to be there, Ginger. It was unmissable.
are you supposed to be gone?
Tomorrow, mate. 6 a.m. Coach from Chippenham. This is it, my lovers. Lee Piper's last Flintlock Fair.
I wouldn't worry yourself, boy. You'll be back next year.
You can get a ticket, mate. One way. Cleared out my room. Put all my old stuff on eBay. Games, posters, toys, CDs.
What do you make?
Nothing. Not one bit. I mean, Action Man utility vehicle. Set of Smurfs. Life-size cardboard cutout with Chewbacca. So in the end, I put everything in 6 bin bags. I lugged it down to Oxfam. The old lady tell me to fuck off. So it lugs it home and I burned it in the garden.
Nice. Final.
Fuck it. Can't take it with you.
You can't now.
I've got 100 sacks standing in Mum's hall and $200 Australian.
How long's that gonna last? A week?
Duck and dive, mate. Watch the pennies. Plus, right, I'm on a fast.
A what?
A fast, I'm purging myself.
Why the fuck are you on a fast?
Cleaning my system. Hooling my willpower. I've been going 2 weeks now. I was on this site, I was on Google buying a ticket, and I saw this site about the Potawatomis.
Yeah, you?
The Potawatomis? The Potawatomis are this double R Red Indian tribe that ruled the Black Mountains of Dakota and terrorized the Bozeman Trail of 1851 to the late 1890s.
Can't you just download porn like any city?
For a great journey, the Potawatomi braves used to go on fast to gain knowledge, you know, spirit quests. You go on a dream quest to discover your true name, your spirit name.
What's your Red Indian spirit name then, Lee?
Burns and Smurfs!
Oh, it's Australia, then come straight back!
I take the piss. I learn loads. Yeah. Just give it a go, you know, that's all. Preparing.
For what?
The journey. Lies ahead. Come Monday, boy, all this is gone. Memories from the other side of the world.
Oh, where is St. George? Oh, where is he? Ow!
Hey, there's the Lord of Mercy.
What's up, Ginger? Mr. Classic, that's my big best one in weeks. Where have you been, eh?
Over there at Dad's with some amazing trees. Are you supposed to be gone?
Tomorrow, mate. 6 a.m. Coach from Chippenham.
Right, did you give me, mate?
I leave Wiltshire. My ears pop. No, seriously, I'm on my bike pedaling along. See a sign says, welcome to Bosch. I turn right around. I do right and we so warm, Bassett. First it's Reading, then it's London, then it's France. This country's popping up all over the place. I can't help it if I'm happy here.
I can't help it if I like it.
Hey, Rooster.
What's that?
Hey, don't touch that. That's my bond paper, that is.
I should be wiping my arse on that, surely,
so I don't want your grubby dabs all over it.
Mate, it looks really serious. It says Ken and Egon Council on the top with a reference number and a seal.
I ain't afraid of Ken and Egon Council. I'm the one who rings here, Matt, I said before you were born.
Hey, Dave,
you smashed my telly up?
No, mate.
You did. Well, look, cricket bat.
Bollocks!
You should have been there, Ginger. It was fucking hysterical.
Roy, I should have.
Bollocks, that's a brand new telly.
Oh, you want to see it? And about I've got it here.
Oh, you don't. My eyes don't work. Here we go. Eddie, look.
You press the fucking middle button.
How old is this?
Is that okay? You stop locking your ears.
Just press it, boy.
Anger Bay? That's Rosie! That's my fucking little sister Rosie!
Who's that? Who's that? That's you. What's she doing? What?
Well, that is a complete mystery.
That seemed a lot funnier last night.
Yeah, you had to be there.
Oh yeah, hey, what the fuck are you doing? Hey,
oh,
God!
That's chicken, that.
No, it ain't. Chickens run here.
No,
Trust me, mate.
That
is chicken.
No way is that chicken. Chicken's greener. That's badger, mate. Possibly fox.
Fucking hell, rooster.
Turn
this
around.
This is a brand new top.
That's badger.
Hell.
It served you right. Why don't you fuck off home like the rest of them, eh? You don't want to stay here. Stay around Hades. No, I don't know. I don't care.
Hey, Tanya, have you seen Phaedra?
What?
Phaedra. My mum says she ain't been home for days.
Oh, I ain't seen her all week, mate.
Who's that?
Phaedra. She ain't been home.
Last time I saw Phaedra, right, was fancy dressed like the Rapers.
Oh, that doormat is a wanker.
Why?
He just is. He's such a twat.
What happened?
She made her own costume, right? Made a real effort. Stitch in sequence. The lot. She turned up with the Rapers, and the fucking doormat turns her away.
Wanker.
What?
He knows your stepdad. He knows she's 15.
Well, half the girls in there are 15.
Sorry, love. You're underage. Off it.
She just bursts into tears. Just runs off into the night.
She's always given off. Once she had a fight with her mum. She went straight up the dual carriageway. 14 years old.
You know what I reckon? I reckon she's been got by your werewolf. Oh. She's been turned away from the Weepers. Wandered off into the night in tears, whereupon a werewolf has heard her tragic sobs. He's followed her through the bushes, and he's pounced. He's torn her arms and legs off, and he's eaten her virgin arm. Seriously, in a day or two, someone finds a bloody patch in the clearing. Just these two fairy wings flapping in the breeze.
Don't say that, that's awful.
I am the Flint Dock werewolf.
I think I'm the brightest as I step along.
You said shut up.
So, please. Why do you care so much about Phaedra Cox all of a sudden?
What, no reason.
Yeah, you're leaving her tomorrow. Never that one of it, baby.
What? Well, I just wanted to say goodbye, that's all, you know. To everyone. One for the road and all that.
Oh, yeah, one for the road.
I didn't mean it like that.
I'll give her you one for the road, mate.
I didn't mean it like that.
I did, you know, look, not now, you know, when I'm not maybe,
plastered in shit.
You know, when I'm not plastered in. Badger shit.
Excuse me, I'm good.
Worth a try.
Squeaky wheel, mate, squeaky wheel.
She'll turn up, she has to. Phaedra Cox is the main queen.
What?
Right. So, she won last year, right? And reigning main queen has to crown the new queen. If she don't show up, Flintark's got no queen. She'll turn up, she has to.
Phaedra Cox is the queen of the fair.
Right, you lot, here he is!
So you've just passed a new law.
From this day on, it's none of you rats is to kip on without written permission from my lawyers. Anyone caught breaking this law shall be strung up by their heels from the highest tree until their dark dead pops.
Roast your boy, then.
I've spoken.
Is that Ken and Avon?
Oh, who's got the urn now?
The new estate.
Oh, they've got a petition up. It's gone to court, they've had a powwow, and they've been adjourned and everything. Crisis meeting.
Crisis meeting?
That's what I heard. It's all kicked off.
They've got a point here, haven't they? Look, I'm not being funny, boy, but you're sat in your new house, you sweat your bollocks off the boy, and then find out 400 yards down the road, there's some ogre living in the wood. Well, you better never say that in the brochure. Detached house, three bedrooms, garden, what with free trough. Free trough, what loves French music, deals cheap flip and whiz, don't pay no tax, and has probably got AIDS. Guaranteed, non-stop, aggravation in danger. Well, you better never said that in the fucking brochure.
He's going to a bar last night, banged in the back like he was going out of fashion.
She's been giving it a long album since Christmas, or longer.
Oh, last year, watching him twigs around with that daft fella pissed out of his mind.
When he fell off the stage, he was bleeding all down his back. Honestly, well embarrassed.
Dread to think what he's got planned today.
We're always like that. 20 years back, Johnny Boyer was the spin off thing. People came from Somerset, Berkshire, and Dorset just to see him.
Do what?
Get his bollocks out. Try and check your mum.
No. He was a daredevil. Used to jump buses on a trial's bike. Local celebrity, mate. Been up there in 1978, he jumped 13 buses.
Oh, was they double deckers?
Oh, I bet they weren't. I bet they were busy bees.
Didn't have busy bees back then. They'd be double deckers, all right. made these open these agricultural shoes in the Flint Off Fair in 1981. He died.
What?
He died. He tried to jump these 20 18-wheelers and destroy his farm, and he fucked it up. He died.
Bollocks.
They pronounced him stone dead. St. John put a blanket over him, paperwork, everything. All the moms crying out for a statue to him in the town square. When they turn around, and he's gone. He's vanished. There's just a blanket with nothing under it. So they followed the train of blood up the field, past the whirler swirler, into the beer tent, up to the bar where he's finishing a point of tally-o.
That's bollocks. I reckon that deserves a statue.
Oh, fuck me.
Seriously, what did King Arthur have to top that?
So, why'd you start then?
Council stepped in, made Daredevil illegal. Come 91-92, main attraction on Friday was some twat in a tent doing snooker trick shots. Balloon animals, smarry fucking Arty.
Throw a sponge in the egg liquor.
Guess the weight of the poorly hamster.
You know what? They should put him in the town square next to King Arthur.
His our friend King Arthur and a fucking great stick on the go!
Johnny Byron, Wilshire's biggest bullshit.
Yeah. Yeah. Hey, Irish. Hey. Hey.
You, Johnny, they had a meeting about you in the village hall, the crisis meeting.
What are you talking about? What crisis?
The Johnny Byron crisis meeting?
Oh, that.
You know that?
Oh, yeah, I haven't. Went to it, actually.
What?
I weren't busy, so I popped along. Snuck in the back in disguise. They all sit down on these folded chairs. All these normal looking people screaming like banshees. They've got snakes on their necks, tearing out their hair, weeping with rage. Everyone gets very red in the face. This one, Kelly Wendy, she's up there, microphone, red in the face. You know what she's saying? Johnny Byron is a filthy menace. Ha! Johnny Byron is a disgrace to this community. And I swear to Christ I was only shagging her last tune. Every time her husband went away, she suddenly needed her skirting board seen to. Doors, bedroom ceilings. Ha ha! I must have painted her house 16 times. And counted 5 or 6 sprinkled green at all. I can't help it if they can't forget me. You watch! 400 yards down there, they're building 78 brand new houses. Them houses are lovely, clean and spanking new. But come 2 or 3 summers, a couple hard winters, those windows will peel. Doors, ceilings, skirting boards. Those houses, trust me, those houses will need painting again.
What the fuck is that?
Morning, Mr. Irving. Early late, Ginger. Look, I can't stay, but I need quick work.
What the fuck's going on, Wesley?
Excuse me?
Wesley, mate, what the fuck are you wearing?
Oh, right, yeah, no, basically, right, basically don't go there. Basically, it's a long story. Firstly, it weren't my idea. Secondly, fuck off, Rory. So basically, I got roped in.
Roped in what?
We're doing a round of St. Cooper's this afternoon.
Who's with?
Me and the lads, full fair.
You in the who?
The boys, the lads, the Flintock men.
Who the fuck are the Flintock men?
It's a long story, really. The brew's idea, they twisted my arm.
So, how long have you been doing it?
6 weeks.
And how long has the Flintocks men been going?
6 weeks. But it's not all doom and gloom, I'm the barley sword bearer.
Who? What?
The barley sword bearer. If it's a big cake, right, loads of bottles of brandy, Tia Maria, Avoca, whatever they call shit. Basically, I cook the cake and distribute it with the women folk. Basically, loads of fertility and the hunt.
And you're comfortable with this?
It's the brewer's idea. They're right going to the fair this year, putting the same material for special ales.
Tell them to fuck off! Tell him it's your pub!
It's a Swindon level decision. Even if I want to do it out of my ass.
It's wrong, Wesley. Something's definitely wrong.
Look, Johnny, I need to talk to you.
And I need to speak to you too, man. Why did you bar from the Coopers, eh? If it's a bit of a frack,
it ain't about the frack, or it ain't about that. What? It's private.
Right, well, I'm off.
Yeah, we're going on with the top
owner. Yeah, I know, my
I've got a change.
Me too. What time you dancing with me?
On an awful bloody day.
I might see you on the wheelbarrow race. Gory, you miss a load of piss bars,
you
know,
there you go too, Gory, crazy set. Are you DJing?
No, he's not.
I am.
He's not.
I fucking am, alright? I'm standing by for the two trips to Cooper's.
Are you?
I fucking am!
Sue never said nothing.
When? Well, last week she said I could see the two trips with me.
Like, one of them, like, you know.
Gets lost?
Yeah. Really crash.
Or see more than it's a dodgy burger.
But there are two trips. There's two trips. So if one trip is a dodgy burger, there's a spare trip.
Well, I would suggest eating from you.
Thanks for letting us stay over, Johnny, when I'm under.
It's not like you asked, cheeky moo.
Oh, you wouldn't have let us.
You're right.
Johnny, can I have a quick
fuck off.
What would I say?
The answer is
just a cheeky gram.
Fine.
Oh, come on, Johnny, it's St. George's Day. Lend us a bluey, Davy.
I'm out. I got pockets of promises off you, chippers. Lend us a tenner, Bruce. Oh, I'll pay you back later, Bruce.
Here's a DVD, Top Gun, Remains of the Fucking Day. There has to be rules.
Your brother Daffy comes here 3 weeks back. Tries to buy 3 grams of whiz with a tortoise.
You're right. You're just a poor fool, you. Didn't you buy your grab? We go ours. When I get Peter, I give him a bluey. He gets half a wrap and a bluey, or 1.5 wraps, the price of one. Johnny gets a tenner, life goes on.
What do I get?
Keep out of this, mate, you're broke.
Okay.
Ginger buys a wrap, we split that. When I get to Australia, I post Tunes the fiver, he runs around to you, you give him a wrap, he sells that to Dave, you post me back a fiver, and I pays you back.
Sounds fair.
How's that?
It's just that kind of thinking, a sunkless economy. Seriously,
this is how it happened!
Come on, Johnny, it's the fair. The fair needs a bit of sparkle.
It's shit when you're slotted. Imagine how bad it really is.
You don't want to do that to us, Johnny, do you? We have an art.
Johnny!
No IOUs! No bartering, no tips, no favours, no never bloody ever.
There has to be rules, yeah? Fair or no fair?
Turn out your pocket, if all you find is handy, off it, sloppy bollocks! I ain't saved the children!
Come and see you, Wesley.
Lovely.
This tastes like rats. I get rid of the bastards.
Listen, I know Sim's got the other one right, but
just what's going on, Johnny?
What? You kidneys up. I try to get sleep off shit.
They're sleeping here.
Well, where would you rather they stay? At the bus shelter on the gas? And he sits warm here.
Tanya Quan, he's 16 years old.
She was pissed last night. You can't have kids wandering around pissed. Plus, I never even knew she was fucking there. What's your pipe collar?
Look, Babe the Cops has gone off again. She ain't been out since Monday night.
So
I know she comes up here with the others. Have you seen her?
You know me, Wesley. I can't tell these rats apart.
It's not funny, Johnny. She's 15 years old. Troy Whitworth was in the pub, asking if anyone had seen her.
Fraser Cox ain't my look, right? She's Ems. She's Troy Whitworth. He's her stepdad, not me.
I just wonder if you've seen her at all. It's just...
Just what?
Come on, Johnny. Look at this. You got kids here day and night, not Johnny. They're drinking.
They're 15, 16-year-old kids. Course they're bloody drinking.
It's not like you don't, sir.
That's different.
What's different of it? Hey, how much a week do you make off the vodka Red Bulls? The brains of it? Goes like this. Kids, love drinking. They're either sitting in the bus stop, shivering their bollocks off, or they go to yours. Or they come in. Everyone knows what they're up to. Oh, their mums and dads. Why? Because they did the same fucking thing. There's not one more dad round here who can't say the word up here. Drinking, smoking, pinning at the rest when there was that number.
Right.
Fuck it. Sue, come here.
Jim? Sue's brother is in the sad wheelchair. I'm bottling up here with him. He's in the bar with two more of duty. And he says they got that bastard bar in the corner. There's no need tomorrow. They're going to talk out with Shield, Six and Dogs. They're going to flush that bastard bar when out of his hole. They've been planning for 10 weeks now. Signed off. Sorry, mate, I don't mind it. I'm just an airwave.
Is that what you are?
Wake up, Johnny. What's that on your door?
Looks like a piece of paper, Wesley.
Piece of
Barn. Love writing to me, I get love letters every day.
Love letter, piece of paper, every piece of paper, listen. Give it a name, Bond Council, in Dunton, 99 States, like...
Hello, you know. Yeah? Do you really think so? Well, you're planning something for 10 weeks and I don't know about it. I got to get through our restaurant. A binocular flash out there through the trees. You can't get the daylight past the roast.
What are you going to do?
You tell Sue's brother Jim to tell all his South Wiltshire families and all their fuckers on the new estate that this is called Rustlesworth. I've been here before, all you bent busybody bastards were born. I had a stone. You try to pick me up, I'll break your spine.
I'll be right, mate, I'll catch you later.
Oh, and where's me? Pick Sue's bomb from, hey?
Right, mate.
Ladies and gentlemen,
I give to you today the annual St. George's Day pageant at Wessex County Fair, sponsored by John Deere Tracks.
I ain't going.
What?
I said I ain't going.
Oh, Rooster, mate, what happened?
Mother's 16-year-old womb. 8 months, 6 weeks, 3 days later, out pops him, smiling, with a bullet pass between his teeth.
Now, first of all, babies don't have teeth.
Oh, boy, you're born with great things. Look, a dagger, and his own set of teeth. He don't need nothing, he's fully equipped.
Right, let's get back to the bullet. Let's get back to the part where you were born on the tip of a speeding bullet.
Don't believe me, eh?
Well, that could be any old bullet.
Any old boy then?
I am the only man to be conceived in two separate postal zones. Born one day early, been a hell of all you buggers ever since. Friends, outcasts, leeches and undesirables, a blessing upon you and this very fine house. Today, we draw a line in the chalk and push back hard against the pettiness, busybody council, and draw them from this land forever. Yeah!
Oi, Rooster Boy, you're merciless leader.
I've decreed to bestow upon you all my bounty. Yeah. Let me free the loose!
Yeah!
Bangers! Yeah! Where is the mother from the minions and more?
Oh, yes, Rooster! Put it forward again! I would like to say a few words about one who's leaving us.
See?
Born in the soil. Son is failing. He's lived a fair score year among us, but tomorrow sets sail for the far side of the world. Lee Piper, you're a pissette. A wizard. And you don't pay your way. But you're only one of these buggers I trust with a lit match, so you have my blessing. Tanya.
May the road rise to meet you. May the wind be always at your back. May the sun shine warm upon your face and the rain fall soft upon your fields. And if we meet again, may God hold you in the palm of his hand. Oh, and if you do want that free one, come back to my mum's and I'll get you halfway to Australia for nothing.
Hey, hey,
Speak one of the good streams, man. I've been very happy here, right? Right.
Steady the bus. Come on, Skip Rookie, the cable tied down for an hour.
Hey, all right. Rooster.
Hey.
Today you've proved you're not just an old jippo.
Right.
Tie us two coats of paint on.
Right.
A dangerous letter they should put behind glass. Strapped to the back of a diving blue whale. And even if he gets us all killed today, at least we'll show up to heaven paid.
Tonight, like a flaming flock of snakes, we will storm flare top village and burn every house, every shop, and every farm. We'll be at the mayor!
Yeah!
Pitch the pubs, rob the tombola, and imprison the worker. Whip into a whirlwind, a rough and army. Unwashed, unstable, unhinged, baffled berserkers that will haunt this godforsaken town. And together, snitch, body gel, shall rise up on Salisbury until the whole estate will jump, dance into our misrule. Yeah! Goddamn, get in the name on them, fuck the new estate.
Yeah!
Afternoon. It's our enemy.
The dastard foe.
Fuck off, everyone! Fuck off, Christy, you wanker!
I see I'm putting it. Excellent. Oh. That's nice, Rooster. Very nice.
You like that, do you, Wesley? Pity you done that all by yourself.
Don't you live on the estate?
Pendragon close at the end.
I see you're enjoying yourself. I see taking a little chap to heart.
I heard every word, Wesley.
Does all know what day it is today?
This, Wesley, is an historic day. For rooster born of my subnormally educated outcast shall swoop and raise your poxy village to dust.
I say we torture him.
With his head, burn him, alive, rip his bells off.
What do you say, Professor? Are we English torturers?
Well, English rebellions, by their very nature, are generally rather bloodthirsty affairs. I suggest we might stick his head on a pike as a dire warning to the villagers.
It's just that thinking that would immortalize you, Professor.
Burn him! Burn him! Burn him!
We look too boys, but the pub's eating, so I have to look you and leave you.
Lee, mate, sooner or sad that, come tomorrow, you won't move us. So we all club together and got you something.
Said he built Stonehenge.
Oh, really? And where was that?
Hang on. When you say a giant, do you mean like a big bloke? Or do you mean like a giant? Like who thought?
It's hard to say exactly because he was seated. 45, maybe seated, so 90
give or take. 90 foot tall,
give or take. So anyways, I go over to him, we get to chatting.
What did you chat about?
This and that, the weather, most of
the weather.
But in passing, he did mention he built Stonehenge.
Oh, Stonehenge, he built Stonehenge.
He didn't make no song or dance about it. He just pointed over yonder and said, see that? Built that. And he said, well, whatever's coming, this is one beautiful morning. And he stood up. He said, I got something for you. He went to his right ear.
And hanging from it was this golden drum.
Big as a kettle drum.
He says, this is for you. If you're in any bother, I need a hand, just bang this drum and up the joints. We're here and we'll come. And then he walked off, clean across the vale. Towards the motorway. I watched him till he was into the distance, like a pylon.
Right, first of all, when you meet a giant, clues in the name. It's not some inconspicuous thing, is it? If a 90-foot giant walked from Land's End to Stourbridge Point in the blazing sunshine, it's at the very least around BBC Point West. At the very least!
Yeah, that's a good point.
I'm not so sure.
What do you mean you're not so sure?
When you're in two minds.
What?
Well, who knows these days? You ask me, BBC Points West has lots of its wind.
You really don't think that'll make Points West a fucking giant?
Well, Points West used to be solid local news. Nobody done the cuts, moved to Bristol. Now it's half the bloody country.
He's right, you know. In broadening its net, it saved
us. Why, you just keep out of this.
Well, the other day I was watching this story about an old lady. 87 years old. Kid jumped in an alley and kicked her to death for a scratch card.
I saw that. Terrible.
Right, and I'm watching it out. And I'm getting that teared up, right? And then I realise it's some old biddy from Wales. Some Welsh nonsense. Good luck to them. I ain't never fucking been there and I ain't never fucking well.
Who's from Barry Island?
Exactly, I mean, who in their right mind gives a fuck?
Local.
You want to gash yourself in a garage in Gloucester? Be my guest. How could I possibly care less?
Show me a good house fire in Stourbridge. Now that's tragic.
See, the way I see it, for local news to make any sense, you've got to at least have a chance of shagging the weather girl.
Where were we? Oh yeah, a 90-foot fucking giant!
You ask me? Points West missed the cunt.
There was off in Norwich in a fence.
They were too busy merging with BBC fucking Belgium.
I think they missed him.
Me too.
A 90-foot giant. The dozy cunts.
Alright, so
I never said who is it then.
What? This drum.
What?
This giant theory, where's that then?
You're sat on it.
Fucking hell, look! Fucking hell!
Check it out, it's carved with some weird shit. Rules,
bollocks.
Go on, give it a bang.
I wouldn't do that if I were you.
Not unless you mean it.
Not unless you really
mean it.
You don't want to send a signal to the ancient joints of these halls, and when they turn up, you have to tell them it's a wrong number.
I have literally never heard such bollocks in all my life.
Don't believe me, Ginger.
Do my guess. Something wrong, Ginger.
Nothing's fucking wrong.
What did it feel like?
You don't believe me?
Give it a go.
Now, after everything you say,
anyone else hear anything to
go? Go on, Lee, go on, my son.
You've been brave, Colonel. Give it a go.
Oh, do you want them to hear you now?
What? Come on. Oh, no.
No. Oh. All right, give us a minute.
All right, everyone on your feet. Please, attention.
Come back.
We'll be back, mate. Yeah.
Sure, we'll be back. We've been paid yet.
Come on, Professor.
Oh, yes. Sure,
hang on, Dyson, we've got to go faster!
You're just gonna bloody stand there, or have you got a kiss for me?
Hey? Come on, leave your shiny here, don't you, Pella?
Quick smacker? Done?
Shake yourself.
darling. Looking well, but everyone's looking their best.
What's that?
It's art. I mentioned it for the tournament points.
Marky, you want some Coke, Pepsi, darling?
I got someone waiting for me out on the road.
Right.
So we're still on there?
Right, yeah.
Good. Don't let him go on the ghost train. He had nightmares for months after last year. I'll come and pick him up around 5.
Right, actually, Dawn, there's a slight problem. I can't take the boy at the ferry. Something's come up. Nothing serious, Lloyd. It's changed the plan. Unforeseen.
Unforeseen?
Yeah, whoa!
Oh! Ricky! Fall that way! He's on your right, okay?
Hello, Dawn.
Wesley.
Oh.
Hello, Marky. Oh, gosh. You're getting big now, aren't you, Marky?
You remember your Uncle Wesley, Marky?
Right, should I pay you now or pay you later? I'll pay you later. See you, Johnny. Go on. See you, Marky. Happy birthday.
Go on, please, Marky.
Yeah, go play the Lara Croft. This here is pretty, yeah? Don't open any drawers or cupboards and don't go in the back room, the floor. Mind there you go.
Excuse the mess. I'm just sending Lee Piper off, you know. My
bird off. What the hell are you doing, John?
What? Oh, that.
Oh, that. Yes, John, that. You know how I know?
Yeah.
Marky told me. His mate, Dash Hill, told him at school. Dashiell's dad's in the South Wiltshire, and he's at a barbecue Sunday, laughing about it with a bunch of other dads.
God.
I get here, and you're sitting around getting pissed with a bunch of kids. The police are coming. They're going to bulldoze this place. You're having a party.
Storm and a teacup.
Oh, of course it is. Marky comes home every day in floods. Scratches, bruises, his background all torn. Your dad don't pay no tax. Your dad's a gippo. He's going to prison. Not my dad, Mum. My dad's great. My dad's the best.
He say that.
Oh, he is, Marky. He's amazing. He's a one-off. He can't even take his own boy at the fair. Can't even promise to your own child. Question. Do you have drugs in there?
Gone.
Where your son is?
Gone.
Because when the police get here tomorrow morning, what are they going to find? Because Marky needs that next. You in prison for 10 fucking years. Marky needs that like a bag on his head.
That boy is going to be just fine. He ain't got nothing to worry about.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
That's a relief. Because this time Monday, at school, when the South Wiltshire fucking bulldozed this, turning to the ground and you're sat in some cell, then Marky's got nothing to worry about, eh? Do you have drugs in there, John?
Don.
Do you?
Don.
Answer me, do you have drugs?
You know I fucking do! Why? You want some?
Fuck off! Don. Fuck off, alright? Fuck off! I'm not in the wrong here! This is my fault! My problem!
Don! Relax! Alright? Sit down. Have a drink. It's all going to be fine, yeah?
Oh, excellent. Well, let's have a drink then.
Yes.
It's fair day. What happened, Johnny? The world turns and it turns and it moves on and you don't. You're still here.
You know what they say, Don, if it ain't broke. It's all going to be fine, yeah? Leave it to me.
I need to use your phone.
What?
I need to call someone.
What about the phone that I got you?
It got cut off.
Oh.
You buy me a phone for a birthday present. Don't worry, Dawn. I'll pay as you go. 2 weeks later, it's dead. It's cut off.
What's the number? Here you are.
still there? Look, he's let me down. I know. Look, do you mind if we take Marky to the fair? We can go to Salisbury another day. You're a sweetheart. All right, I'll see you in 10 minutes. All right then, babe. Ta-da.
What are you doing?
Deleting the number.
So where is she?
Me. Terrific. I met a fantastic man and get some great with your boy. How are you?
I'm alright. Don't last me, because bad. I had a run with 4 traffic wardens. So I was at the bear, right? And I got caught short on my way home, so I parked down the side street. And I'm having a Jimmy Riddle on the back. When suddenly these 4 big traffic wardens, they come out of nowhere, saying I pissed on their car. Top shot was, they bundled me into the back and all sat on me. Drove me to the outskirts of town. I was held captive for a week.
Kidnapped by traffic
wardens. Hey, I was quite up in their basement. That week I learned more about the life of a South Wiltshire traffic warden than I thought I'd ever know. They walk miles, long, long days, hard, proper, rubbish pay. Anyway, I didn't swallow nothing for a week, and I got thinner and thinner, till the ropes loosened. When they weren't looking, I threw my coat off onto the flame to muffle it, inched up the chimney, out onto the rooftops, and away I went. Apart from that, there's no complaint.
Hello.
What are these? Bootsies. Oh.
Are you up the pole, dog? You are, aren't you?
It's none of your business.
Are you pregnant, Dawn? Are you having a baby?
No, I'm not having a baby.
Then what are you knitting booties for, Dawn? What are you knitting booties for if you're not having a baby?
It's work.
What?
Work. Lots of people do it. It's when you do something for someone and they pay you for it. No? It's a mail order company. People who have babies what can't knit phone in. They ask for hats, jumpers. The woman who owns the company, she has a pool of knitters. I'm one of her knitters.
So, what's his name? Come on. Bob? Pete? Leonard? Cornelius. Archibald. Henry. Adolf. Cornelius. No, Beauregard.
It's Andy.
Andy? What kind of stupid name is that?
Grown up in a bus to and from prison.
Who
says the South Butcher are getting anywhere near this place? Who says they're getting with 100 metres of this place, eh?
Right! I'm sorry, I forgot. That's stupid of me. I forgot you're Spider-Man, fucking super tramp. What planet are you on?
Same one as you, dog. Same one as you. Come here.
No.
I ain't gonna join up. Just come here. Seriously, just come and stand here, hey?
John?
Come and stand here. Come on. I'm gonna show you something. You need to look in my eyes, hey? Come on, look. Yeah. Now, what do you see?
Black.
Yeah. I keep looking. Deeper. Now I'm gonna show you something. Are you ready? Did you see it? Doctor, did you see it? Did you see it?
Yeah, I saw it.
There now. What's the worry? Hey! Who won our grass?
She's gone.
Oh, right, it's at the repair shop.
She's got the fair love. Come see your friend. The clothes arrived.
Yeah, don't spend it on candy floss or football cards. I have a go on the wireless for me, eh?
Say goodbye to your father,
man.
Goodbye.
Oh, he's got a hug, boy. Oh, super, sir. How about you, dog? How are you, dog? Eh?
Goodbye, John.
Sun, sand, surfing, adventure, excitement, the unknown, spiritual growth.
Okay, I just want to be absolutely sure we're on the same page. When I say free, I mean no streams, even if I get pregnant.
Tanya, it's not that I don't appreciate it.
Oh, bollocks, Piper! If you're not going to eat my peaches, don't shake my tree.
Tanya! I listen to the offer, I respect the offer, but I will not eat your peaches.
Oh, your food.
There we go, Professor. How's that?
Much better, thank you, P. Much better.
That's it, you sit there.
P.
What are you doing?
What? Nothing.
What is it?
Coke me.
Oh,
no. Sorry, snooze, you lose.
Bastards.
For 10 points, what was found under the patio of Ten Brookside Coast?
No idea.
Anyone?
Trevor Jordak's body.
It's correct. Who was the star of Paper Tiger?
Paper? I've no idea.
David Niven.
Question 3. How many English horse races are defined as classics?
Boy.
Okay, how the fuck does he know that?
Alright, you lot! You wanna play a game, eh? Make some money. First to 10. Whoever wins, I'll give him 50 quid.
Bottoms.
100. 100 to anyone who can beat.
Go on then.
Okay, here we go. Which word indicates a liquid is able to resist flowing?
Viscous or viscosity.
Which is the largest body of water in the auspices of Bolivia's 6,000-man army?
Lady Diaka.
Who the fuck do you know that?
Everybody knows that. You got a buzzer, here's it.
Which composer was the work first to win 3 Oscars?
Barbara Nanlish.
What's going on?
Which play whose line better knows than Glenn Judge?
Hamlet.
You've learned these sodding
questions. Are you accusing me of cheating? Just say. Yes or no? Are you accusing me of cheating?
Yes!
If you are,
get out my wood.
What does a brave mantis have that most of
them are?
No. How do you know that then?
You are a bunch of losers. If you know nothing, you should have said.
Deprived of virtue to the glorified FBI.
Fuck it out, you should have
said. Which brush cleaning chemicals?
Perfect point.
Which tunnel detective?
Sorry, Lord Peter Wendy.
Which archaeologist?
Tierra del Fuego!
Professor, we're going down in flames here.
Professor?
Professor? No doubt. Elvis is that the little bit?
She's dead!
Oh my god!
She's fire coat.
She ain't dead! Look at her! She's having the time of her life!
Come on, you little girl, come on!
Which Olympic race?
Vicky Dale's a male one!
How sad did I have to learn every question, every card of the fucking Genius 2000 edition? If you're saying I'm that sad, get off my land!
What is that?
The man on the edge of one pen.
It's correct.
Hey! I'm magic, me. Magic fucking Johnny Boy, you're in.
Oh, he's got X-ray vision. I'm just going to. I left in 10 pounds to 50 quid on getting the next one.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Go on, then.
Who wrote the words to the popular inn, Jerusalem?
Fuck. I don't.
Shit,
wait,
Johnny!
Troy. Good afternoon, mate. Welcome to our banquet. You call it a party product.
Nick,
what? That shepherd, I'll let the stuff worth it, Aaron. You've been
to the fair today, you win anything?
Grab a party then. Day, ain't it? Come on, girl, shit, don't make room.
I ain't safe.
It's no bother, Troy. Come on, what are you drinking? What about you?
Are you deaf, Jippo? I ain't sitting with you. Where is she?
Who?
Who's trying to buy her? Where is she? Where is Phaedra?
Phaedra. Hang a bit, which one's she? I got her. Bring it in, yeah? Breakfast. Big eyes. She's a treasure, she is. Lovely big eyes. Ain't she the May Queen? Queen of the Bear? She is, and she gotta be back. She don't wanna.
Regulars.
Sure.
Turn the fuck off! This is between you and me.
There's no need to break up the party, Troy, eh? Thor your mates! Your brother, Danny! Yeah, they're always down here every summer,
Get rid of them, now!
Troy, what say we bury the hatchet, eh?
And you dead, Jippo! We bury the hatchet, alright? Breaking your fucking skull, Mikey! Now one more time, where's my daughter?
She ain't your door!
Shut the slapper!
Troy!
Don't call me a slapper!
Just open your fuck hole one more time or shut the
hang on, me!
You want some too?
No. Troy, mate. You're worried. Of course, what bother wouldn't be? She's young. 15. She shouldn't be here. It's not right. It's not safe. Or is it you're just feeling a little bit randy?
What did you say?
She your treasure, boy. You miss her. She in your dreams.
Shut your happy mouth.
When were you last here, Troy, eh? Last in these woods. Christ, I don't think I've seen you since you were 15, 16 year old. Do you remember the night we took the pack of cards? The old one with the devils on the back. We laid them out there in the dead of night in a circle. It was pitch black. We took a wine bottle and we poured it into a plate, a silver plate, until it was like a blood red mirror. And you took a candle to that mirror and you started shaking like a leaf. Couldn't stop
shaking, couldn't speak. From that day on, you never came to see me again. From that day, I never saw you. You come to play a game, boy? I got the cards. You want to play a game?
Nothing changes up here, I says. All except the faces. All except Ginger. He was here when I was here. What happened, mate? Got lost. Couldn't find your way home. I tell you, Rooster, Frank and Danny was up here all last summer. They come home 4 or 5 in the morning. Tell me all the stories they did. Tell me this one. End of June it was. You were going to see the rooster shake him awake. Well, they're travelling down on the path. And guess what they find lying out on the floor out cold? Sparko! You pissed yourself, mate. All over your trousers and in your coat. And do you know what they'd done? They undid their flies and they pissed all over you too. Took photos with their phone. I bet Lee's got it on his phone. P, Tanya. I know Davey has. He filmed it. Go on, Davey. Show me what you've done. Tell me all the stories, Rooster. Took me back. Nothing changes up here, I say. When you're alone, Jippo. When you're alone.
Boy, when we were at school, yeah, he had the worst eczema I've ever seen. We used to call him Cornflakes.
Ginger, he was a wanker too.
Thanks. What did I do? I never pissed on him, I only filmed it.
I can't believe you don't.
Fuck off, you laughing, right?
Yeah, it's not funny, is it? It's not funny.
Oh my God.
What?
I'm coming up.
Marvellous.
Oh, for fuck's sake, we've got a marvellous one.
Come on, let me better go.
We're not here.
Oh, don't worry, I'll come back or iron that out. Let's go.
There once was a knight called Saint George, born in Cappadocia. From a time came to the province of Libya, to a city named Selene. And by this city there was a stagnant pond, wherein dwelled a dragon which envenomed all the country. And when he drew nigh the city, he scorched the people with his breath. There was an ordinance made in the town that all the children and young people should be taken by lot. And each, as it fell, were he gentle or poor, should be delivered unto the beast. In time, a noble knight passed, and when he beheld the mighty creature, he said unto the citizens, "Now doubt ye no thing without more. Believe ye in God, Jesu Christ, and do ye be baptized, and I shall slay the dragon."